Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to a new video on my channel. Today I'm gonna do a script presentation, a script that I created a while back. Those of you who watched my 2000 subs video might already know what I'm talking about. It's Actor Galore, of course, the actor editor script that I created a while back. It's finally complete, or at least bug free, maybe, let's hope. And before I get into the nitty gritty, and that's a new word for me to use, don't forget to don't forget to support the channel by doing the stuff that every YouTuber asks you for, you know, like and subscribe, all that magical stuff. Also, I need to say a big thank you to the Patreons. Thank you so much for supporting the channel financially, and I wish you the best. So yeah, that's it for the intro. Now let's just get into it. For the first part of this video, I'm gonna teach you how to download it and how to install it on your server. For this demonstration, I downloaded a brand new server, a SAM server from SAM.com. I'm gonna download it and unzip it on my desktop. And after that, I'm gonna rename the server folder into something less confusing. Now go in the description of this video and click on the download link I left you there. It should bring you to my GitHub page. Now click the download code button, then press download zip as shown in the video. I'm gonna save it on desktop as I did with the other server and then unzip it. Great! Now that you've done that, go in the Actor Galore folder, select everything in there, copy them, and now we'll go inside the test server folder and paste all that stuff in there and replace the folders. Cool, now we need to tell the server to load all the stuff that we just tossed in there. To do that, double click the server config file and open it with Notepad or Sublime Text or Notepad++, whatever you choose. Now find the filter script line, go at the end of it and type Actor Galore, just like I did. Now you need to find the plugins line. And if you don't have it, just hit enter and type it yourself, just like I'm doing. Then add a space and type these two plugin names. And if you are using Linux, make sure you type the proper extensions so that it's loading the Linux variant of the plugin. And if you already have these two plugins specified in there, you don't need to do anything else. Just save the file and close it, and that's it. Now, if you just run the server, it should print some info in the console regarding loading actors and default animations. And this is the installation process. I tried making it as simple as possible. But if you somehow still have any problems in installing it, make sure to tell me down in the comments and I'll try to help you as fast as possible. Now, just boot up the server and log in, and let's find out how you use this tool. Although, first you need to be Archon logged so that you gain permission to use the commands. And if you don't know your password, just go again in the server config file and check it there. So, first things first, let's create an actor. To do that, you just have to type /an actor, followed by the skin you like your actor to have. Let's say 50. And boom. Actor acquired. And if you don't know the skin IDs, just Google some skins and click on the second result. So now you have an actor, but how do you make him move and do stuff? It's easy. Just type /aanim and followed by the actor ID displayed in the label above him. And now just pick an animation from the list. I'm gonna pick this one. There are over 40 default animations for you to pick, and you can even add more, but more about that later. You animated your actor, but let's say you didn't position him properly, so let's change that. You can use this command, aedit, followed by his ID, to move him around easily. This is quite similar to Texture Studio. You can also use apos to teleport him at your position. It even retains your facing angle. You can even use /atp to teleport your actor add custom coordinates. Just like that. To change the skin, it's also quite easy. You just have to type a skin followed by the actor ID and then the new skin you wanna choose. Let's say, let's say 8. Deleting the actors, it's also very easy. You just have to type the actor followed by the actor ID and kaboom, gone. It's magic. Let's say you created a bunch of actors and now you're happy with what you got. How do you add them to your server? It's very simple. Just type /export followed by a name. The export file is going to have and that's it. All the actors you created got exported in code format. To find that file, you just have to go in the script files folder and then access the actors folder, and you should have it there. Now open the file, copy everything inside it, and then paste it in your game mode under the on game mode initiate callback. Compile your codes and enjoy your actors. And this concludes the commands you're going to use the most. There are a couple more that I'm going to quickly describe, although you can use actor help to check them yourself or in case you forget some along the way. So you can also use a labels to just, it's simple, it's quite self-explanatory, isn't it? To just hide the labels above the actors. And if you use it again, it will display them back up. There is also a inv, which stands for actor invulnerability. And if you do this, the actor will get invulnerable to moving him around with vehicles and stuff like that. By default, this is disabled for all actors, but you can switch it back. Unfortunately, for now you need to do it individually. And these are all the commands regarding the actors. But we're not done yet. You remember I said earlier that you can add your own animations to the list. That brings us to the next part of the script, the animation library. This is a new feature I implemented recently because I thought that the default animation I added weren't enough for everyone. So I added this new feature. It's quite simple in terms of commands. There are just two of them that you need to use. The first command is animAdd, and as you may have already guessed, this is used to add new animations. To add a new animation, go to this website I'll link down in the description and follow my example. For the command to work, you need to provide an animation library name and the animation name that is found in that respective library. For example, I'm going to use this third one here, the bar library, and I'm going to copy one of these animation names. Now go back to the game and type animAdd, add a space, type bar with capital letters as shown on the website. Now I'm gonna add another space and paste in the animation name that I copied earlier. Hit enter, execute the command, and the new animation called new animation has been created. It's very important to write the animation library right or you will crash the game for everyone on your server. And if you happen to make that mistake, go inside the script files in the actors folder and delete the animlib.db file. And that should revert the animation library to its original default state after you restart the server, of course. Now, in order to edit animations present in your library, you need to type /animedit. After that, select the animation you wish to edit. In this case, I'm gonna select the animation we just added. As you can see, there are a few options you can mess with, and I'm not gonna go into detail here because most of them are self-explanatory, and when you select them, you can see what they are for in the dialog displayed. But for the sake of demonstration, I'm gonna select the listing name and change it from new animation to something that defines the animation. And this concludes this presentation. Using this editor, you can make your server really stand out from the hundreds of other servers. And combine it with Texture Studio, you can really tell a good story. The download link is down in the description on my GitHub page, and if you find any bugs that I might have missed, please go there and create an issue post, and I'll surely patch it as fast as possible. And this is it for this video, guys. If you guys found it useful, make sure to smash those buttons, follow me on the social media, and if you wanna support the channel financially, go check my Patreon page. All the links are down in the description. See you next time. Bye bye. And stay awesome. I forgot to tell you.